SchoolFreeware's QBasic Tutorial Series, Tutorial 18, Read and Data Matrix. Tutorial 18 will build upon the code made in Tutorial 17. All code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com, and this tutorial will use QB64 running on Windows 7. This is the program made within Tutorial 17. This program makes a two-dimensional array based upon the information found in the suit and rank arrays. What I like to do differently with this program is change how the suit and rank arrays are loaded. As you can see, the code for loading in the arrays is long and drawn out. So what I'm going to do is use the read and data commands to shrink the size of the code. I don't need this rank or suit code here. I'll then go to the end of the program and put in data. Here on this data line, I'll put in the information for the suit array. So within quotation, D, comma, S, comma, H, comma, C, comma. In another data line, I'll put in the information for the rank array. Within quotation, 2, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, 5, comma. And I'll go ahead and enter in the rest of the data, ending with the ace. Okay, now it's time to load the suit array. So what I'll do is go here and put in 4x equals 1 to 4, since we have 4 suits. Read suit x. Next x. So what's going to happen as we go through the for loop, x of course will be 1 through 4 within the loop. We're going to read the data line, placing the information within suit x. So as the loop goes through, read will enter in D, then S, then H, then C within the array. Now comes time to load in the rank array. 4, and in this case I'll use Y, since I use Y within the rank here within the two-dimensional array. Y equals 1 to 13. Read rank Y. Next Y. So the read command will continue placing the information within the rank array, starting with 2 and ending with ace. So when I go ahead and run, the program's functionality is exactly the same, but as you can see, the code is much more compact using the read and data commands.